Let's talk about secondary indexes, which are vital for using a database correctly. Many performance issues can be traced back to queries that don't use one. In this lesson, we'll talk about how to create secondary indexes, how to find them for a given table, and how to determine how an index is being used for a particular query. Secondary indexes, often just called indexes for short, are built by CockroachDB either at table creation time or later with the create index command. Let's see how this works in the shell. This SQL script creates a table called users and populates it. Let's run it, then go into the shell and see what's there. Here, we can see the users table created by the SQL script. It has 5 rows and 5 columns. The first column, ID, is the primary key. Let's find out what indexes are there with show indexes. Okay, we have only one row here. The index name is primary, which actually is a label just for the table. The primary index is the data structure that holds the table's data, sorted by primary key here in ascending order. Since the primary key is unique, the non-unique field is false. We'll ignore everything else for now. Let's run a query, filtering by ID. We get the one row back that matches, but we don't know anything about how the database got us that answer. To find out, we'll ask it for what's called a logical explain plan. In general, you'll want to read these from the bottom up. The scan section is what we'll focus on, and it tells us two things. The table field tells us we're looking at the primary index, while the spans field tells us that it's not looking at everything, just the part where the ID is at least one and not more than one. CockroachDB was able to find only the relevant row by using the primary index. Next, let's ask for the same row, but this time specify first and last name. While the results are the same, the explain plan is quite different. It's still looking at the primary index, as we can see in the table field, but it's not able to use it efficiently. That spans all means it looked at every row of the table. This is called a table scan, and those are awful for performance. At the bottom, we see this filter operation. After reading each row into memory, CockroachDB is checking to see if the columns match the query. It's a lot of work, but it's necessary because the primary index can't be used to filter by first or last name, only by ID, which our query didn't specify. What we'd like to have is a data structure that's ordered by the columns in the query and that tells us the primary keys of the row we want, so we can look it up in the primary index. Actually, that's what a secondary index is. Let's create one. What are we seeing? First, this index has the name I gave it, myIndex. It's the same for all of these new rows, so all three refer to the same index. Next, it's not a unique index because I didn't create one that way. The following two fields, sequence in index and column name, tell us about its structure. Last name comes first in the index, first name comes second, but then comes ID. CockroachDB implicitly appended that column. It did this because of its underlying key value store, which requires unique keys. Appending that field ensures uniqueness even for a non-unique index, and I'll need that field anyway since the primary key is what I'm using the index to find. The next column tells us all fields are sorted in ascending order, the default. Let's rerun that explain plan now. Much better. Again, read from the bottom up. From the scan section, the table field tells us we're using myIndex, and the spans field tells us we're hitting just the part that matches. There's no filter field because this time we got only the rows we asked for. Above that, we see an index join. That's there because after CockroachDB got the primary key from myIndex, it had to look up the row in the primary index. That operation is actually a join labeled as an index join here. And that's how to create an index, find indexes for a particular table, and find out how a query is executed by the database using the explain command.